All righty, thank y'all for coming.
We want to ask all the kids to come up, 0 to 18. You come up and we want you to help us do this little lot of time.
Come on, we got more than this.
One right there.
I see a bunch of them, come on, set them down. All right, it's a simple song.
Yeah, stop your feet like that. Let's clap together. That's it.
Services. What a great looking crowd this morning. Thank you for being here this morning. In just a few minutes, we're going to go to the Lord in prayer. And, just to kind of repeat and making sure everybody hears and you can add to your prayer list. Victor Basile. Victor is in Waccamaw Community Hospital with pancreatitis. I was with him yesterday and he is doing better. And we're hoping he'll get to, and I know he's hoping, that he'll get to come home today. So remember Victor. Roy Wyatt and Michael Moose, infant Michael Moose. That's Lisa Smith, Dexter's Lisa. She's got a brand new grandbaby, and it's Michael. And he was born, I believe, Friday. I may be wrong, but he is brand new. And he has two holes in his heart, one upper and one lower. So please, she's asked for prayer for infant Michael. Brother Randy Hardy, he's with us this morning, and he'll be having back surgery middle of January. Please add him to your prayer list. The Harold Spencer family, Addison, Jace, Riley and Briggs, is that Crud? Riley and Briggs, If you didn't hear Shayna earlier, but Darius Apache, their family used to attend here, now they're attending New Beginnings. And this morning, they're having a service for him. He's leaving next week. This coming week to be a part of Uncle Sam's army. So please be in prayer for Jennifer and the family. And I know Justin, he always does a great job with our announcement. Just one little small correction. Wednesday night, there will not be Bible study. Okay? Happy New Year. That is New Year's Day, and a lot of you have already shared with me that you won't be here for whatever reasons, black eyed peas and collards. But no services. I have missed y'all this week. I don't know if you've missed me. I don't believe you have, but I heard from any of you. But I've missed missed you this week. And as soon as kind of we get Wednesday behind us, everything will be back and back on track and our schedules. And don't forget, please don't forget, the Lottie Moon service next Sunday evening. Is that Finger Foods also? And please bring Finger Foods, okay, for a time of fellowship following that service. Thank you. God bless you. If you would, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we pause once again thanking you for this day, Father, that you blessed us with. Father, thank you for your spirit that's among us. This Sunday school hour that we just come out of, Lord, thank you for the teachers and the teaching. And Father, we ask that you continue to bless and manifest yourself this time. Father, I see kind of a trend starting with our, if you allow me, Lord, with our little kids opening up with this little light of mine. And so, Father, I pray that however and wherever we've come from today, Father, you have ordained and orchestrated this moment for us to be. Father, this morning the sanctuary is full. So, Father, you have placed each and every one here today that you wanted to be here, I truly believe. So, Father, as we approach and as we continue to worship you in spirit and song, and in truth and in your word. And as this morning worship service, Lord, continues to open up, Father, for us to be filled with the fullness of your spirit, Father, I pray now that each and every one will just kind of take inventory of their life. And Father, just simply ask ourselves, are you the light of our world today, Lord? And are we shining that light? Do other people know that we even have a light? And so, Father, we thank you for your son, Jesus Christ. Father, this special time of year where we celebrate his birth. And Father God, anytime we think about his birth, Lord, we have to also think about his ministry, his life, his teachings, his word. And then, Father, his death, the prophecy of that, Lord. But Father, today, as in every day, the believer should celebrate the resurrection. And so, Father, we thank you for that. We dealt with a question this morning. Are every religion's the same? And Father, I don't believe the answer is yes. Father, I believe the one and only true. The one and only true God. The one and only true living God is your son, Jesus Christ. And Father, it's because of him that we're able to be here this morning and worship you. So Father, I pray for your continued presence and blessings and anointing on this service. Father, thank you for this time of prayer. And as we think about and we call out the names in our heart, and those names have already been called out to you, Father, we ask for your blessings upon them. And all of those, Lord, that are dealing with sickness, diseases, and death, and dying, and finances, and faith. Father, the things that are going on around us and within us. So, Father, may we right now just continue to trust in you. Have that faith in you. Because, Father, you're not going to falter. You're not going to be shaken. Our refuge is in you this morning. And we acknowledge that, and we thank you. And Lord, in just a moment, as we take up our offering, Lord, as always, God, we ask that you bless it. Father, that you bless the gift and the giver, Lord. And Father, then you bless us. Help us to be good stewards of what you've given us. So, Father God, we want to thank you again for listening to our prayer, for not only listening, but being with us in the asking, God. Lord, we love you and we thank you. And it's in Jesus' name I pray. And the church said, amen.
We got a devotional Bethany's going to read for us. For y'all real fast, we want y'all to hear it as well, and Abigail has some scripture to go with.
This is a devotion by Sarah Young, and it says, "As you journey through life with me, see the hope of heaven shining on your path, lighting up your perspective. Remember that you are one of my chosen people, belonging to me. I called you out of darkness into my wonderful light. Savor the richness of these concepts. I chose you before the creation of the world, so nothing can ever separate you from me. You belong to me forever. I drew you out of the darkness of sin and death into the exquisite light of eternal life. The brightness of my presence helps you in multiple ways. The closer to me you live, the more clearly you can see the way forward. As you soak in this love-drenched light, I give you strength and bless you with peace. My radiance blesses not only you, but also other people as it permeates your whole being. This time spent focusing on me helps you become more like me, enabling you to shine into the lives of others. I'm continually drawing my loved ones out of darkness into my glorious light."
And this is 1 Peter 2:9, and it says, "But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light."
We're singing "Learning to Be the Light." We're all in a process. God is still working on us, and he's teaching us how to be his light in this world.
When the stars came crashing down, tied pieces to the ground, I was all alone down here, trapped beneath the atmosphere. And I thought somebody called my name. I stood on the water plane, waving to the cloud I did. Oh,
Sunday, we have one every quarter, and the youth takes over. We always try to come up with something to do. And anyway, with it being Christmas time, started thinking about lights. Me and my wife, we raised a boy named Jamie for a little while. Y'all probably met him if you come here a little bit. Anyway, he's my wife's nephew, my nephew, and I used to take him deer hunt. Well. When I would take him deer hunt, we'd always sit in the deer stand till after dark. Well, our house was, I'm gonna say, 400 yards from that deer stand, in an open hayfield. And you could see the house, you know, because there's most time of light on. But he'd always want to hold the flashlight. And I'd always try to convince him, you know, cut that light off, because you can see more than just what's in the light. When the light's off, you can see other stuff about, you know, moonlight or whatever, foreign light. And you don't stick out that much, but you know, and he would for a little bit, but then he always had to turn that light back on. Anyway, I tried to convince him to cut it off, but in all truth and reality, Daniel was right. You know, he needed that light on. We need to keep that light on. That light represents what we should be to the world. They should see us as followers of Christ. We should stand out. We should stick out. When you shine a light, you notice what's in that light, and you see it with all clarity. If you look at something in the darkness, it'll lose color. It'll lose shape. In the darkness, our focus is not right. We're far apart from what reality is when we're in the darkness. We just sang a song, Learning to Be the Light, and the youth I took some pictures throughout this whole year, and a couple of other people have sent me some pictures. And anyway, we wanted to show you where God has put the youth throughout this year. Little slideshow, and there's some pictures we couldn't use because they were blurred. I mean, you gotta remember, we were taking these with phones. So, and this doesn't have everything, but it's just got a couple of things for y'all to look at. So, it's a short slideshow, and we'd like for y'all to like to see this. Matthew 5:14-16. Y'all can look it up if y'all like to, or y'all can read what's on the screen. But we're focusing on light this morning. And the light, if you look it up in the back of the Bible, and I have because just trying to dig deeper and figure out exactly what to say and how to say it. But it starts in Genesis 1:3. And it says, God separated darkness from light. And it goes all the way to the very end. In my book, it was like two columns, near about a whole page of scripture related to light. So if y'all would stand with us as I read, please. If I miss up reading on that, but, you are the light of the world. A town built on a hill cannot be hidden. Neither do people light a lamp and put it under a bowl. Instead, they put it on its stand, and it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven. All right, y'all can be seated. Let's say a prayer. Lord, thank you for this day, Lord. Thank you for everybody that's here this morning. Nobody's here this morning on just coincidence, Lord. I know that. You know that. Lord, help this scripture. Help me to be able to represent it the best way that I can, Lord. Put your words in my mouth. Take my words out. Take my mind out, Lord. And you speak through me in the way that you have it spoken as well. In Jesus' name, amen. Take a look around the sanctuary for just a second. And I know it's Christmas time, but look at all the lights. I want you to tell me which light is light of this sanctuary. It's not one, it's a bunch of them. And now the source, which we know runs with electric, is where the source came from. They're the ones that's powering each one of these lights. But every light in this room is contributing to lighting the sanctuary. That's how we are with God. God is our source. But each one of us should be a light for Him and should be lighting the way and pulling back towards Him. Same goes for y'all with the youth group. Y'all are the light for the youth group. Y'all's light points and shines them in the way to go. This morning, the youth group, really what we're saying is thank you for being the light. Thank you, Pastor Jason, for supporting us in being the light. Thank each one of y'all for supporting us. Sheena, Miss Rhonda, Nick, Joe, Brother Miss Rhonda. There's so many that put time and effort into supporting all our youth. And some of you aren't up here right now, and they should be put anyway. The parents. Whenever you say, well, I didn't do much. If you're a parent, you brought your child, how big of a light is that? It's y'all, a smile. How are you doing when we pass by? All those support being more than you know. And y'all living a Christian life and letting God's light shine through y'all shows them how they need to be and where they need to go. So the youth wanted to say this morning, thank you for being the light. With y'all being the light, y'all kind of take on the form of an angel in their eyes. So this morning they got a song, or we got a song that we're going to sing about how y'all are angels to us. Thank you. I was walking home from school on a cold winter day. I took a shortcut through the woods and I lost my way. It was getting late and I was scared and alone. And a kind old man took my hand and led me home. Mama couldn't see me, but he was standing there. And I knew in my heart he was the answer to my prayers. Oh, I believe there are angels among us, so sit down to us. From somewhere up above, they come to me and me. In our darkest hours, to show us how to be, to teach us how to be, to guide us in the light. Had me down on my knees. There's always been someone to come along and comfort me. Like I were from a stranger to lend a helping hand. A phone call from a friend
just to say I understand. It made it kind of funny at the dark end of the road. Someone lights your way with just a single ray of hope.
I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere out above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours, show us how to live, teach us how to give, guide us in the light of
life. They wear so many faces, show up in the strange places to grace us with their mercy in our time of need.
Oh, I believe there are angels among us, sent down to us from somewhere up above. They come to you and me in our darkest hours, show us how to live, teach us how to give, to guide us in the light of love.
God has blessed you, say amen. Brandon asked me to come alongside of them this morning to close the service out. And he says, if you would you please give the invitation? And I tell you, it's a joy and a pleasure to come alongside of the youth group and be able to be a part of it. Because as someone said a while ago, you're 0 to 18, come on up here. So I'm up here. And it feels good. Got you laughing, I got you listening. Man, when Jesus said what he did, of what Brandon read, talking to the crowd there, the side of a mountain, delivering the Sermon on the Mount. And Miss Faye carries him there and he says, cover it up. You uncover it so it can be seen. And then he goes on to say, so let your light so shine before men. That sounds pretty direct, doesn't it? It almost sounds like a not a good idea, but a command. And if I'm your source, let it shine. Amen. He's got them up there, right where he wants them. He's got them strategically placed for that sermon to make more sense, if you allow me. And then he went on to say, I'm sorry, I chased the rabbit. He says, so let your light shine before men so that they may see your good works. Hold up now. Wait a minute. What, Jesus, is this about me? No. Don't get Pharisee on me. No, don't do that. You see, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works from the source of God Almighty, of the source of Jesus Christ. Because when they see that, when they see the right light, they'll glorify your Father which is in heaven. Amen. Somebody say amen to the house of God. Amen. That's the source. Some of y'all are going to judge me with what I'm getting ready to say. I've never been in a tree stand. And guess what? Nah. So Brandon, I've never been like Jamie and coming out of the woods from hunting with a flashlight, but I've definitely been in the dark with a flashlight, haven't you? And even though that light from the house, you could see it, and the starlight and the moonlight could light that path with a little bit of struggle, with a little bit of strain, it could light the path, and by golly, you could probably make it, especially if you're familiar with the path. And when Brandon shared with me what he was reading, because if I'm gonna close this, I kind of wanted to know the scripture. I got to thinking about something else. And Brother Mike's helping us this morning. Mike, if you'll go ahead and get the instrumental ready for the invitation, sir. None of this has been rehearsed. Christmas Eve night, we each of us, if you attended, each of you had a candle. You turned it on. I got to thinking about that candle, and we talked about the light that night. And it's been said that if you're on a mountain and all of the elements are right, if all the elements are somewhat perfect, that the light, or I should say the brightness of one candle, one flame from a candle, can be seen for up to 30 miles away. If you've ever been up in an airplane, it's real easy to see the cluster of lights down on the land. But that one flame can have the effect of up to 30 miles in distance. It can be visible. It can be seen. If the elements of the darkness and the moonlight and all of that is correct, that's pretty outstanding. Wouldn't you say? Are y'all okay?
Yes.
But what about our light? Are we letting people see it from 3 feet away? Are we letting people see it from in 3 minutes of a conversation? And may I tell you that if you're a child of God, tell me when the elements are not right, when the Holy Spirit moves in your life to witness to someone else about God. Every time the elements will be right. Every time. Because God's own time. So has the message from, listen to me, has the message of God this morning, from God, spoke to your life? How's your light? Are you sharing it? Are you showing it? You will, if He's your source. Father God, move now in only the way that you can. Lead, guide, and direct. And in Christ's name I pray. Amen. Would you please stand? Moment of meditation. Moment of worship. The altar is open. Maybe you're here this morning. Maybe you're here this morning and you don't know about this light, this person that we're talking about, Jesus Christ. Well, I'm here to tell you that He is the way, the truth, and the life. And no one can come to the Father except through Him. I will tell you that this man named Jesus is identified as the light of the world. And He should be our source. So, in essence, can I ask you a simple question? Do you have a relationship with Christ this morning? Do you?
And if you do, are you in a state of not loving him today just as much and more as yesterday? Well, sir, ma'am, if that's the case, you've backslidden. I've backslidden if that's not the case with me. So how are you today with all that you've heard? As the youth being the vessel this morning of God, what have you heard this morning? What is God saying to you this morning? I just ask you now to be obedient. Said, amen. Brother Brandon, I'm going to turn the service back over.
Closing prayer. Anybody got anything to say before we close?
I want to thank you because you are a shining light for this youth group. You sacrifice a lot, but you do it out of love for them. So thank you and thank you. I love you.
Our Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you for this day. Thank you for this time, Lord. Thank you for the fellowship with fellow believers. That we may grow in your word. That whenever we go out amongst this world, we're ready for battle. We're ready for battle for you. We're ready to let our light shine amongst those around us, Lord. It's easy to let our light shine here, Lord. Get us to prepare us, Lord. Thank you for that fellowship. Lord, help us as we leave here and that we do let our light shine. Open the opportunity, open the doors, to give us the knowledge to be able to let it shine. That is opportunity. In Jesus' name. Amen.